Okay, thank you for the introduction, and thank you for having me here. As Vatsal said, I'm one of the co-founders of the Collective Ministry of Space. I was trained as an architect, and then I did my PhD in the urban planning. Since I like learned through the practice that the whole fun is actually in the urban planning field. So Ministry of Space, it's the activist collective that is mostly interested in public property management and different models of governance, urban and spatial planning, especially participation in decision making and affordable housing. And we do these things under the umbrella of, like, let's say, urban commons. We do that through practice, research, and education. We also have different programs, like residency program for activists, especially those who are facing the burnout. And we had it until Corona, and we do a lot of grassroots support in Serbia. We started as a squatter collective in 2011. So Vaslav was also he was playing in one of the venues that we squatted and activated like 10 years ago. And we managed to activate several public property buildings in Belgrade. But one of the things that we are like super well known in Europe is this movement called Don't Let Belgrade Drown, which we initiated in 2014 when this project here, Belgrade on Water, was introduced to Belgrade as a new identity and economical vigor for our country. So this is basically 100 square meters, 100 acres of luxurious hotels and households and the biggest shopping mall in this part of Europe and the highest tower in this part of Europe and everything, the biggest and highest. And basically it was given for free to the private investor. Coming from Abu Dhabi. We initiated the protest against this project from 2014 and managed to bring 25 to 30,000 people on the streets of Belgrade for like every 2 weeks in 2016. I will not go into details with this project because like my head will explode out of it. And I mean, there is a lot of material in English online about it and like video materials as well. But why it's this is kind of the departing point for me, it's that we managed after this protest to kind of politicize the question of urban planning in Belgrade. And there is a noticeable number of community initiatives that are now kind of empowered to react on different investors' urbanism in their neighborhoods and like asking for some kind of support. The general, it's not the general impression, but the facts about the urban planning situation in Serbia is that it's a rational approach, it's very top-down, it's striving to minimize participation and presenting urban planning as exclusively professional field, which is also, of course, politically neutral, which is a complete nonsense. And then the main characteristics are it's not transparent, it's not participatory, there is a lack of protection of public interest in the majority of plans, lack of horizontal and vertical collaboration between the institutions. We have two legally allowed mechanisms for participation. This is early public insight, when you see like the draft of the plan, and it lasts like 15 days. And then we have a public insight followed by the public discussion with the planning commission where you can discuss basically your objections and comments, which last 30 days. And what is really kind of the noticeable over and over again is that like the constant conflict between the citizens and the institutions, and also citizens and private investors on the field. So after the protest against Belgrade Waterfront, the initiative Don't Let Belgrade Down was then built as a political movement. And we, within the Ministry of Space, we split into entities. Half of the people went to build the political party, which is now going for the elections next spring. on the city level, and half of us stayed in the Ministry of Space trying to kind of engage more in these urban planning issues. And we created several years ago this crisis headquarters, Krisenstab, which is basically a service or a format where we are trying to support and educate people about different urban planning issues. So we go to different neighborhoods who have the plan that is accurate. We're explaining them the level, the size of the plan development, what they can do. We also write the objection and file the objections in their name, and we are preparing them for public discussions too. Based on our experience, we created several manuals, which are also making our life easier, but also just to illustrate, usually we work with let's say approximately 20 groups per year. And last year and this year particularly, we worked with among 50 to 60 groups in Belgrade in Serbia. And we don't have resources for these kind of things. So we created one guideline, which is how to defend your space. And it explains the whole process for like creating a neighborhood Viber group to like filing the case on the court, like all the steps that you can imagine, both formally and informally, how to engage media, neighbors, and so on. And then these guidelines to the planning procedure. And these guidelines to the planning procedures are basically like every single thing that you can imagine that you can find in the plan is described on the website. And we also have this glossary where you can find different elements that are usually on the plan so people can understand it. And then we go to the neighborhood and additionally explain all the things that are characteristic for the plan and that people should know when they're filing their objections. And to illustrate how the public discussions are looking in Belgrade. So this is but today we had a similar case, but this is from the last year when city decided to adopt the plan of building 4.5 million square meters of housing and offices on the water springs of drinkable water in Belgrade. So there were many people against that plan, and then the city decided that they will introduce the procedure where you cannot enter for a public discussion. So they sent even the police to kind of stop people of entering to this session. Another thing that I just want to also like briefly show you, it's we are now in the very unique opportunity of having drafted or not having drafted, we don't know, the plan for Belgrade, like the general urban plan for the whole area for the next 20 years. And it was announced that it will be that they will start doing the plan in 2019. But even now, and now it's the end of 2021, we didn't saw like any single paper or decision or like news about it. So we decided to draft our own plan and to engage as much people as we know into this campaign, which was called Belgrade 2041, Back to the Future. So it was created in several phases. So the first phase was we have a problem, and those are like short video forms up to 1 minute where different experts and activists were commenting and like mapping the problems in Belgrade from protection of environmental protection, urban mobility, housing, participation in urban planning, and so on. Then the next phase, when we invited artists to create their artworks that are basically showing a very dystopic future of Belgrade if everything continues in this direction. Then we had a series of conversation with the institution representatives on the green infrastructure, participation, housing segregation, the quality of air, climate justice, and urban mobility. The third phase were like learning from local initiatives, or how we like to call it, like warm human stories, where we basically presented what actually people are doing, and like grassroots are doing in Belgrade, how they're trying to really create and engage in building their environment. And these are like dozens of different stories from like energy cooperatives to let's say building parks, creating parks and trying to make their environment much more friendly for the neighbors. And then in the fourth phase, we did the public opinion poll. It was in July, June and July this year. And some of the key findings I want to share with you. So the general conclusions are that more like half of the citizens of Belgrade are agreeing that the city is developed according to the private interests of the powerful, that the city is territorially unevenly developed. 62.4% of the people feel as if they are not involved in the planning processes, and 49% that they are not informed about the city development and major projects. Top problems and priorities are traffic, 72.5%, and environmental protection. And it was really interesting how people agree on like the importance of the green spaces, clean air, recycling, and different things. That even when we ask when we asked about the traffic and the parking problem, which is really a burning issue in Belgrade, they all agree that they will not support building parking slots on the green areas, which is now taking place. And the number of green areas in Belgrade, it's like 12% of the total area. And let's say Berlin and Vienna are like 52 to 53, basically the half of the cities under the green infrastructure. And then the final phase was the short movie. It is 23 minutes movie about the future of Belgrade, where we try to address how things can be done. About 10 to 12 people are speaking about the solutions. It's also translated to English, so it's available on YouTube with the subtitles. And we brought again experts and activists to speak about climate justice, housing, traffic, green infrastructure, and so on. And finally, to end up with this, also I don't want to be negative, so we are very optimistic about the things that can be done. We are now diving in into this new mechanism that we are creating called participatory forums, which we are going to introduce in 2 weeks. So we are using the fact that we are working with the local communities with different initiatives, and also the fact that some plans are between the phases, so between these two insights, to create this mechanism where we will bring the institution representatives, decision makers, experts, and citizens to discuss about the best solutions. So we are trying to see if that might be something that could be formally adopted and decrease the level of conflict that we have nonstop, and also using the opportunity that the elections are in April next year and the government is a bit more open in order to get more support for their future power. Thank you.